Welcome back to Sports Chat.
503
Southeast.
The up Oregon. In
Portland. That's yep. right. That's right. Represent Portland. Today, man, we're just too fired up on this draft.
Yeah.
Too fired up, people. We got to keep talking about this stuff, man. Yeah, it's crazy.
It's good. It's like good. It's like watching the NBA, NFL draft. I mean,
it's very, very fun. And most important is this. People all want to hype up about the whole first round. But it's really the second, third, and fourth where teams build their team.
Yeah, that's where you get all the kids that...
That's the meat and potatoes.
Yeah, all the kids that are going to make up the base of your team. You'll have a couple big-name players on your team, sure. But, I mean, that's where you're going to fill out your roster at. And those are the guys that are going to be putting it down. So
exactly. Unofficially sponsored by today. The guy who wants to tell me the secret of life is actually just... to calm down, enjoy, smell the roses.
Yeah,
take a walk.
Yeah, learn to eat a Tangelo, not merely consume it.
Yeah, take a break, take a walk. Now I understand all about trying to be relaxed. I'm cool with that, but we also try to do a lot of stuff in this life. We got not a lot of time and a lot of stuff to do.
Yeah.
I got a job. I got a family. I got other stuff. I got you, Sports Chat. I got you.
Yep. Keep the comments coming. We're going to give you some updates on the NFL draft right now.
Let's do this. NFL draft. First of all, second round. We didn't get to this. After our last video that you guys want to watch, maybe up here, down here, wherever it is, YouTube. Here's the thing. Clawson got picked up. And we were just like freaking out because I think Clawson is a great pick for the Panthers.
Yeah, Panthers.
Carolina got hooked up with this. We, Sports Chat Nation, me especially, I love the Ducks. And the Duck that I love in the pros right now is the best running back we've possibly ever had, which is Jonathan Stewart. Jonathan Stewart is so for real. They also have D'Angelo.
Yeah.
Right? So this like thunder and lightning sort of stuff, right? They call it. Clawson works. They got rid of DeLome.
Yeah,
Clawson's a perfect fit there.
Yeah,
talk to me.
Yeah, Clawson's a good fit. We were both talking about how he's kind of a pretty boy, Southern California type guy. But I think being down in Florida will work for him a lot better. We were joking about. Imagine if you went to like Philly or Pittsburgh. Murder. Yeah, Buffalo, someplace like that.
I think Carolina's perfect.
Yeah, so I think they'll do good down there. It'll take him a little time. I don't know if he's going to be the man right off the bat, but
I think
he'll be okay.
Yeah? I think he will.
You think he will?
I think he's going to be the starting quarterback on day one.
Nice, man.
Yep.
That's good, man.
I think they got great value. And here's the other thing. Are you going to seriously pay that little dude, that guy who some people have been calling this, that, and the other? Are you going to pay him that much amount of money? How much more of that would he be?
Yeah.
So if dude's already a little bitch, and you pay him $50 million, what's he going to come up to practice with?
Yeah, he's going to come up with that $50 million attitude.
Yep. This time, he's not even guaranteed he's in the second round, man. He's going to work. For real. He might be the most NFL-ready quarterback out of all of them.
Yeah, and I think he's got the most to prove. I mean, Tebow's showed you a lot in college.
He's pissed.
Clawson came out
early. He was terrible. Notre Dame sucks.
Yeah, yeah. Notre Dame was terrible.
He was the number one quarterback in the country. He could have gone to SC.
Yeah.
So, he went to Notre Dame and blew.
Yeah.
His best game, I saw the interview he had with Gruden, his best game was against Purdue.
Yeah. Oh, I remember that.
That was a fucking warm-up game for Oregon.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, yeah.
That's a warm-up game for Oregon, Notre Dame. Yep. Hey, my family went to the game. I didn't want to go because I was 4 years old and the shit hurt too bad. My ears hurt too bad. But that 1982, we tied Notre Dame. Notre Dame was awesome. If Oregon played Notre Dame today, be a 40-point blowout.
Yep.
Wouldn't even be close.
Yeah.
We'd run 300 yards on their asses.
Yeah, man.
And we'd throw for 200. Four or five touchdowns all day long against Notre Dame. Clawson is a good quarterback, but Notre Dame is crap.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I like that. I'm totally on your side on that.
I mean, come on.
Yeah, I don't like.
So he's Notre got Dame. Something to prove. Yeah. He wants to get to the pros and say, "Fuck Notre Dame, I'm going here for real."
Yeah. So yeah, he's got a lot to prove. Plus, I don't know, man. Down in that division, he's gonna have a kind of a hard time. I don't even know who the backup or who was going to be the starting quarterback for Clawson was.
Well, I think they had the guy there last year who did pretty well. I can't remember his name.
Gerard.
I think it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, I liked him.
Yeah, me too.
I liked him early in his career.
Yeah, yeah. So that's pretty good.
Here's the other big one, though. We're stoked about this. West Coast. We're all about West Coast. Taylor Mays goes. So Taylor Mays goes to the Niners. That's great for the Niners. Yeah. That's huge. Niner fans, represent Taylor Mays.
Yeah.
That's a great pick for them.
Yeah, I like Taylor Mays. SC, big-time DB.
Here's the thing for him, though. I don't think he should be a safety. He needs to be closer to the line.
Yeah.
He's not as fast as Polamalu. If he can run like Paul... First of all, they got his time completely wrong in the draft combine. I watched the combine. They say he ran a 4.2. And then they came back a couple days later and said, no, that's wrong. He actually ran a 4.4.
Who, Mays?
Yeah, at the combine. They got it wrong at the combine.
Wow. Of all the places where he can't...
Mays.
Can't keep track of
him. Yeah, he left that day thinking that he ran a 4.2. That is not the case.
Yeah.
So he is not the speed of Polamalu, I think. He's very similar to Polamalu in the fact that he's big and he's physical and he can play deep, but he can also play the run.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I think Mays is best at that attacking the run, not playing deep, because Oregon torched their ass.
Yeah.
Scored 44 points. We scored more points on SC than we did Cal.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we wrapped that game right here, baby. Cal. Yeah. So here's the thing, exactly. So here's the thing. Here's the real deal. Yeah. Taylor Mays is going to be a better pro than he was a college player.
Yeah.
The reason why is because everybody's bigger in the pros.
Yeah.
Here's the other one. West Coast. Gerhardt. What do you think? Toby Gerhardt.
Gerhardt, yeah.
Goes to the Vikings.
I was just going
to
say that, man.
Minnesota.
That's huge, man. They just got a perfect backup.
A great running back.
Yeah. I think the guy could have won the...
Who's durable.
Yeah. I think he could have won the Heisman.
Easily.
Yeah.
Easily. He had the numbers. Anybody else who had those numbers would have won.
Yeah. And he's not like a dance around kind of back. He goes straight in the line and he drags people. So.
In the old days, he would have won because they never would have given it to a sophomore.
Yeah.
They gave it to us. Tebow's the first sophomore to win.
Yeah.
Tebow!
Yeah.
But here's the other one. Ingram wins as a sophomore. They would have given that to Gerhardt.
Yeah, I think so.
Even 5 years ago. But especially 20 years ago. That's Gerhardt's award.
Yeah.
So the Vikings, to get Gerhardt, what number did they get Gerhardt?
Yeah.
At 51?
51.
51? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's pretty big, man. I like it. So we got Mays down there at San Fran. Got Gerhardt going out to the Vikings. Yeah, I think that's a steal, man.
Yeah, and I like the guy who the Steelers got. I like the defensive end they got there. We were talking about earlier the Broncos. The Broncos pick up an offensive tackle from Utah. That's really nice for them. Again, Tebow.
Yeah.
You're getting you're kind of new regime change a little bit. McDaniels is kind of working the whole thing over. He's shipping people out. He's let go of the best quarterback they had and the best player they had.
Yep.
Yeah, Brandon. Marshall's, he's gone. Marshall's is gone.
Yeah, he went to Miami.
Yes, he's gone. He's the best player they had.
Yep.
And he was pissed the whole year. Again, TJ Ward to the Browns, we're stoked on that. Brian Price is really big. But look at the Vikings as well, getting their cornerback, getting Chris Cook from Virginia. That's big as well. A bigger cornerback, 6'2". Again, these guys, I'm impressed. I'm impressed with how the draft is put together this year.
Yeah.
In years past, let's do this real quick. Is the draft better because it's on the Thursday night, and then you get the next day, the second and third round on a Friday, and then you get Saturday, Sunday?
Yeah.
I think so. I think it's a win-win.
Yeah. Real quick, do you think the Panthers did a good job taking Clawson over somebody like a Colt McCoy?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think that Clawson is more NFL ready. I think that Colt McCoy is easier to coach.
Yeah.
Colt McCoy might be – I heard Tilford today say Colt McCoy is going to win more Super Bowls. What the hell does that mean?
Yeah, it means you're still bald, Trent Dilfer.
But and he was close, though, didn't he?
Yeah. Well, with the Ravens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He won one.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Right. But he was close in other ones, wasn't he, too? Did he
play another one? I don't know, man. Who cares?
Who cares? Dilfer, though. No, I think Clawson's better than I think Clawson's better than McCoy. I think McCoy also has injury.
Yeah. Yeah, he did. Yeah, he got injured down at Texas. So.
I just think that Clawson's best fit would be a West Coast thing, you know, Niners, that sort of stuff.
Yeah, I think so, too. God, that'd be a dream job if you got one out with the Seahawks or something like that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just you know, somebody who's comfortable, somebody who's a good coach, somebody who's comfortable with them. I think the Panthers are going to be good, though. I mean, I think John Fox does a good job down there. I mean, I think the key thing is they have running backs. If you have running backs, you're going to be successful. Look at what Sanchez did last year. Yeah. Had one of the best running backs in the league. Jones, guy runs for 1,500 yards, 1,400 yards or something.
Yeah, Sanchez.
That's a great job for Sanchez.
Yep.
Hand the ball. Peace. All
right. Be good.
SCP.